been discussing. Perhaps the one message that the government has tried to send out is, if you don't pass on benefits to consumers, we're watching and we will come after you, anti-profiteering or not. Adarsh Shetty, president of the Indian Hotel and Restaurant Association, joins us now. Mr. Shetty, appreciate you joining us. So the rate is now 5%. It is without any input tax credit. The government making it clear it believes the restaurant sector has not passed on the benefits of the goods and services tax, and hence this decision. Your first reaction?
Absolutely, we are absolutely happy about it, and we are very, very thankful to the government, to the GST Council also, for getting it to 5% without input credit. There's no, as you mentioned now, it is one of the, probably one of the best decisions that have gone so far. And we are, as the restaurant industry, I'm sure all of us would definitely support this. And we would definitely, you know, we are quite happy that today, after it's been long overdue.
But what about the charge, Mr. Shetty? You're saying you welcome it. You are saying you welcome it. But what about the charge that the government is making that restaurant owners have not passed on the benefits to consumers?
It's not like that. It is absolutely not like that. There are so many instances, and we have actually discussed this with the government also, that the restaurant has passed to a certain extent, because whatever we could pass on, we did pass on. Whatever with the raw material cost.
How much was passed on, sir? How much was passed on?
On an average, how much was passed on?
On an average, how much was passed on, Mr. Shetty?
I think average 5 to 12% was passed on, and it was quite a fair amount because the raw material cost post GST and pre GST would not fall down for quite some time, and it was going stagnant. You see, last week also the vegetable costs were going up. So the prices of raw materials were not going down, and whatever best we could do under those circumstances, we did. And I think the restaurateurs and the restaurant fraternity in large have welcomed this, and we are sure that in coming times, what is expected out of this industry, the industry will deliver.
So, Mr. Shetty, if I were to go to a restaurant on the 15th of November, because these rates come into application only from the 15th of November, if I were to go to a restaurant on the 15th of November, how much of a reduction can I expect on my bill, sir? That is the question that a regular consumer would like an answer to.
See, our menus don't change periodically, okay? They change once in a year. And that happens in the month of January, and some happen in the month of March. But from the last 1.5 years, we were expecting GST. We had welcomed GST, and we had always said we were always open to a GST regime. Unfortunately,
One second. Are you saying that come the 15th of November or even a few days after that, we are not going to see a reduction as far as rates are concerned?
No, there would be some
reduction.
For the consumer? There would be some reduction. There definitely would be some reduction. At the same time, the tax burden on the customer also would be withdrawn, because from today 18% is too much. 18 to 5 is a very big jump, and definitely that 18 to 5% jump at the point, the cost reductions also will happen. Appropriately, it will happen as the prices.
Now that input tax credit has been done away with, we had the specialty restaurant CEO telling us that they would in fact have to hike prices. So what do we make of this?
No, I don't think so. It was opinion. It was the opinion that the operational costs, because the operational costs, the overhead costs, the operational costs haven't come down. That was the reason why they were saying, a particular section was saying that we'll have to hike up the price. It's not like that. But I think this reduction from 8 to 5, Is such a huge, humongous reduction that we feel that there wouldn't be any. Even that time I said that there is no need to panic without ITC also, because we feel that this is quite a humongous jump from the government, and we look at it positively, and we feel that there won't be.
You mean
a humongous cut from the government, not a jump. Try to moderate it, and
Mr. Shetty,
as the time goes on,
just hold on, sir.
To the customers also.
Okay, just hold on. We've also got Rahul Singh, Vice President of the National Restaurant Association of India, joining us. Rahul, appreciate you joining us. Adarsh Shetty saying the restaurant industry welcomes it. What is this now going to mean as far as consumers are concerned? Because the finance minister making it clear three times in that press conference, he's not happy with the restaurant industry in India.
Hi, Shireen.
Hi.
This is Rahul. Okay. So let's just go into, you know,
why
GST came up.
Yes,
I can. So the GST, the premise around GST has always been it's a destination-based tax. And it works on how what you look in your bag. So in a restaurant, when a consumer comes and is serviced, you get a GST bill on your menu and you go away paying that. The consumer is not getting an input tax for that. That's the final payment that the consumer pays. But that tax that we get from the customer, we have to do a backward calculation to claim the ITCs in order to deposit the balance off of the tax liability that we have to pay. Now, if I'm going to stop looking at my back, I'm stop looking at my ITC, which means there will be a lot of unregularized and absolutely an informal economy which you're bringing up. A cascading of tax is something what the whole GST concept was all again. That it's a destination-based tax. You have to make sure
you're not in agreement then. So
not
just one second. So then you're not in agreement with what Mr. Shetty is saying. He's saying they welcome the move. You're saying you don't. You're disappointed.
We are absolutely disappointed.
Okay.
Because
so
it's
you're
against
saying
the grain
that
of
this
GST.
Is in fact...
it's against the
It's against the grain
of
GST. You're saying that it's against the fundamental principle of
GST. Absolutely. That is what
GST is.
Otherwise,
what does this now mean? Because the government has made it clear that this is the way forward.
No, so we already had a composition scheme. If you recall, restaurants always had a composition scheme of paying 5% GST, not get an ITC for people who had 75 lakh rupees of turnover or 1 crore. I'm talking about, we stand for an organized restaurant body, okay? We are not talking about a pop-and-mom store. We're talking about an organized chain, which will obviously be more than a crore rupees worth of turnover. Now, if you have, and that composition scheme has become 1%. So if you're a 1 crore restaurant, you pay 1% composition fee. If you're more than 1 crore restaurant, you pay 5%. So in any case, how can you have two composition scheme rates to start with? That's one point. The other point
I think the restaurants are out of the composition scheme, is my understanding. Restaurants are out of the composition scheme now. Is my understanding.
Okay. So now coming back to that means we are now coming to a composition scheme, which means we are a 5%, we don't get an ITC, and 5% of the GST we charge the customer. Correct? Okay. Now where this lands up is you've got an ITC. Now how do we monitor? I'm your gatekeeper. So if I look at it, ITC I can only claim in my electronic ledger only when the person who's a service or product provider to me has actually paid the tax. If they have not paid the tax, I don't get an ITC. Yeah. I, in fact, have to pay interest also for the ITC that I've claimed and I've not been able to see it in my electronic ledger.
So one second, gentlemen.
Yes. Yes.
You know, this is going to confuse a lot of our viewers. So very simply, let me ask you, Rahul Singh, you're saying that this makes your life as a restaurant owner worse starting the 15th of November, and you will in fact be forced to hike prices. Is my understanding correct?
Financially, I'll give you, it'll go up because the cost goes up by 10 points, which means a 100 rupee product on the menu becomes 110. So you're paying on 110 rupees, you're paying a 5%. So if you look at it from a consumer perspective, he'll pay 115 rupees 50 paisa for what the consumer was paying 118 rupees in an AC restaurant earlier. So the consumer will get a benefit.
Okay.
118 will become 115 rupees 50 paisa in a AC
15.
Restaurant. Yes.
Okay.
10% hike in cost will definitely happen because that is how it will work. That's A. Secondly, yes, our compliance cost will go down because we don't have to look at the ITC at all. But it'll really increase the informal economy because landlords will not pay GST. The people who are supplying us chairs and tables will not pay GST. We are not going to watch them. Nobody is going to be paying GST. I think the government is going to be really shortchanged.
Okay, the government is going to be shortchanged. That's the view here from Rahul Singh. Adarsh Shetty, you feel very differently about this. So clearly, the Restaurant Association as well as the Indian
Hello.
Hotel Association is
Hello.
Split down the middle on this issue.
Hello.
Adarsh Shetty, respond there to the point that Rahul Singh is making, that
Hello.
He's disappointed with this decision. He's not happy.
Hello?
Adarsh Shetty, can you hear me? Can you hear me, sir? We seem to have lost that line, Rahul and Adarsh. We'll have to leave it there. So split down the middle. That's the view they're coming in from the hotel and restaurant business on the decision taken by the government.